BBC Radio 3, 90 to 93 FM on digital radio and online. And now, Late Junction with Robert Sandall.
Hello, we're off for the wide open spaces in tonight's show, some of them evoked by the piano virtuoso Brad Meldow on his remarkable new double CD, Highway Star. But America isn't the only inspiring landscape we're tumbling after. This is the Viennese guitarist Christian Fenech taking a clear-eyed view of his Central European home, Black Sea, a cool through composition. Here we go.
Thank you. Thank you.
The Ghostly Sounds There of Fenech and Black Sea. That's the title track from his album of the same name. Now, for his new record, Highway Rider, Brad Meldow is reunited with the polymathic arranger and film score composer John Bryan. These are probably the most ambitious arrangements either man has ever attempted, and you have to listen to them at length, frankly, to get their measure. Luckily, on Late Junction, we can do this. So, from the top, this is the album opener, John Boy. John Boy by Brad Meldow. Two pieces now in which the artists sketch their southern roots. Mary Gauthier is a foundling, born, as the song title suggests, on March the 11th, 1962. Ry Cooder's famous instrumental is the immortal theme from Paris, Texas.
Why I'm calling, I don't know why. something. Don't leave me hanging here like this. If there's something right to say right now, I don't know what it is. This is the hardest thing
Goodbye.
Kuda with the theme from the film Paris, Texas. How do you follow that? Well, not by trying too hard, I suspect. So, here are Home Life from Manchester. And this is one of Paddy Steer's most attractive and amusing soundtracks. It points us at a Hawaiian world that he's never visited, and nor have I, which is why I loved Home Life's exotic interlude. The gloriously insouciant Home Life and the title track from their album Exotic Interlude. Now, Kurt Wagner of the quirky American country band Lamb Chop knows how to croon out his bashed-up blues. Lamb Chop's record Damage is a classic reclamation of the detritus of an inconclusive life, summarised here by his paperback Bible.
got some things that I'd like to put on out there. Like a pony cart in an old bird bath, a kitchen safe in a rocking chair. You can turn me on almost any day at noon. He's a male, and he's marked up pretty in everything. This woman's got some goats, but his feet's never been on the ground. You can just buy one, or you can have the whole. Color TV has to be non-working and RCA, 'cause I need the part. And daily there's an old drive shaft and the same Berkeley recliner. It's green and it's claw. Been used very little. Strapless, but this one's lit above the knee. If you're looking for something perfect for that student, I have always thought that handguns were made for shooting people rather than for sport. Why not use a rifle in most other applications? You might find a shotgun or a musket, but you'll never hear a pistol. There may always be looking for finding some. Guess I'd like to sell a good used paperback living Bible.
Aaron Copland's chorale Nocturne from Rodeo, and that's played by the London Symphony Orchestra, conducted by Aaron Copland. The Norwegian jazz composer Lars Horntveth is a more abstract electronic figure from the Scandinavian Jaga Jazzis collective. This is a 9-minute self-contained extract from a 35-minute composition, Kaleidoscope, which Horntveth wrote in 2008. And I'd like to slide it into a piece of juicy orchestral Americana by the great Van Dyke Parks. Thank you.
should spire before you retire and finish an also ram. It's fun time to drink tea from China.
Van Dyke Parks there with the clang of the Yankee Reaper. And don't forget, you can catch Van Dyke Parks at London's Meltdown Festival this year on the 18th of June. Back to Brad Meldow now. We're still in the foothills of his Highway Rider epic, a record that travels over 2 hours into the orchestral interior of a world jointly imagined with John Bryan. Here's 8.5 minutes of its sublime jazz-tinged ramblings. Thank you. What a beautifully sinuous melody that is. That's Brad Meldow and Don't Be Sad. Now, we're going to leave Meldow for a while now to follow in the footsteps of a couple of equally bold American explorers, the guitarist Bill Frisell and America's premier classical composer John Adams. First up is the theme from Frisell's American opus Disfarma, about a southern photographer, which I followed with the third part of Adams' Dr. Atomic Symphony, Trinity.
Thank you.
John Adams, and that was the third movement of his Dr. Atomic Symphony, played by the St. Louis Symphony Orchestra, conducted by David Robertson. So you see, it isn't all alt country and experimental rock music here on Late Junction with me, Robert Sandall. But now back to music that touches closer to home, quite literally. The English singer PJ Harvey has been spending half her time in Los Angeles recently, but sadly that doesn't seem to be working out, and she wants to leave. Sounds rather like West African bell ringing to me. That's a track from the album Ali and Tumani. It's called 56, very simply. And it's a sort of swan song, I suppose, for their occasional partnership as one of West Africa's most blissful string duos. Still, there's plenty more from Brad Meldow to fill our ears, and here's Walking the Peak from Highway Rider.
Thank you.
Walking the Peak by Brad Meldow from his terrific new record Highway Rider, a double CD which is well worth listening to from start to finish if you can spare it the time. Now, I leave you tonight with an expedition into the inner mind of Vladislav Delay, an electronic composer who's as thoroughly North European in his way as Brad Meldow is North American in his. I hope we've taken you to some interesting places in tonight's show. Join me next Tuesday for a few journeys by drum. Good night.
Thank you. Hello and welcome to BBC Radio 3 Through the Night with me, Jonathan Swain. All roads lead to Rome, so they say. Certainly they were very likely to in Renaissance times. By the late 1500s, when Palestrina was in charge of the papal choir, the Vatican's Sistine Chapel had been in existence for well over...